Because, I mean, they already look beautiful on their wedding day anyway. Is it easier for you?
well, that's where a relationship with the bride comes into. Like, say, mm-hmm. you, because I meet the bride and groom early, mm-hmm. and we talk, like, get to know them, what kind of people, like, what kind of characters are they. So then, when at the wedding day, like, I can, like, refer, like, say, if the groom is, like, say he certain job, he does a certain job. Mm-hmm. I make jokes of that job just to make her smile. So that the picture that was shown before with the veil,
beautiful picture.
Yeah, it's just before she left for the church. Mm-hmm. Just put her close to a window and took that shot.
And I mean, these are all things that you can sort of play around with.
Yeah.
And it's a bride on her wedding day.
Yeah.
Do you go for real crazy poses? It's called a crazy pose these days, isn't it?
But yeah. Well, we like not only like we do the normal safe poses, but also we try to get more of the bubbly, more happy kind of pose. That all depends on the this is the picture. All depends on the bride itself. Mm-hmm. This she
I'm
looks
sure
really
the bride
happy,
was
right?
Very happy with that picture as well.
It's I made a joke to her saying that like you're getting married. It's your biggest day, and then she's smiled. That kind of emotions is priceless. Mm-hmm. Because when she sees that picture, she remembers like what I did, my crazy stuff. Because you have to act crazy. If not, they won't get that vibe.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, it's sort of the joy of going to the church. I mean, going to the church just before you get married.
Yeah.
It's all just there, there in the picture. But again, now, when you speak about wedding trends as well, again, another beautiful picture. Now, this is, I'm going to say this is not natural lighting.
No.
Okay. I'm correct.
Yeah. Actually, I'm trying to mimic window natural light. Mm-hmm. But this was taken around 8 p.m. which there was no light at all. So to mimic that window light, mm-hmm. I use strobes. Strobes is like flashes, mm-hmm. to mimic that light, because I try to, if I could, I would use natural light. So to give that natural effect to that, I didn't blast her with light, but because her dress had a lot of texture to show that.
Yeah. It brings it out beautifully. But again, when you speak of wedding trends, another big trend is the pre-wedding shoot.
Yes.
I don't think that was very popular in Sri Lanka just a decade ago, but now it's all the rage when you have a wedding, isn't it? To have a themed pre-wedding shoot, that sort of thing. Do you find that becoming very popular these days?
Yeah, well, every wedding, except a few brides, a pre-wedding shoot is like a must. Mm-hmm. Because they want picture. They want actually better features than, you know, all their cousins and stuff. But that's normal. So, yeah, people spend a lot more sometimes on their pre-wedding shoot now.
I see.
Than the location, because some places in Colombo are pretty exclusive. Mm-hmm. And it's like really expensive to get those, but people spend that to get a good pre-shoot.
But and then and they are there to make the magic happen as well.
Yeah.
So now I'm going to ask you about how we when we are posing on the other side of the camera, how you can look better in pictures. I'm sure lots of people would want to hear how that can be done as well. We're going for a very short break, but we're leaving you with Avicii's Wake Me Up. Welcome back to the show. Now, this is a very important segment. We're going to tell you how you can look good in photographs. I'm not going to do that. And Dylan Peeting is going to do that. I'm going to ask him about being photogenic. I mean, you get people who are naturally photogenic, right? Yeah. They always look good in every picture that they take. And then you have people like me who have to try very, very hard to look good in a picture. So I'm going to ask you, what are some of the insights or advice that you can give when it comes to posing for a picture?
Okay, so mainly I would say is confidence.
Okay.
Confidence will give you a picture to start from. Mm-hmm. And then a great smile. like anyone with a good smile can light up a room, actually. A picture that like a person really smiling actually will give a feeling of very, you know, like feeling of like
joy.
And if I'm taking it, you should have a good picture.
And make sure design is behind the camera. Yes. That's what I was saying. But it is, I mean, and there are so many different poses that people do now as well. I've always wondered what's the best way to pull off the duck face, you know, the you pout a bit. I'm not going to attempt that on national TV, but these poses, do they work as well?
Not exactly, but what I say is like, but we do say a group of friends get together, mm-hmm. they do this duck face stuff and all. Yeah, for a fun shot, yes, but continuously doing that doesn't work at all. For me, that is not a which I would like want people to see.
I see. Okay, yeah. Okay. All right then. Got the message there. But now, obviously, you've done a lot of work in the past 3 years, especially when you've been working as a professional photographer. But what are some of your favorite moments, favorite weddings that you've been a part of, things that really stand out for you?
Oh, well, my very first wedding that I had, a Russian wedding in Pasigoda, that was like one of the like the first my exposure to an international wedding. It was pretty different. I mean, there was only about 12 guests in mm-hmm. that, and it was all, everyone was so close to them, and that was like lovely moments that I got. That was a special wedding for me. Mm-hmm. And yeah, there are few of Sri Lankan weddings that I have shot that when I got to the wedding day, they were so friendly with me. It was like flawless. That they went uh-huh. so quickly that they were like, in the end of the wedding, they thanked me, saying that mm-hmm. You made the day so like not very stressful and all, and me smiling all the time, but them want to smile throughout the whole day. Yeah.
So even when you're behind the camera, I'm sure you have this same smile all the entire day as well. But how do you handle it when, I mean, things can go wrong as well,
yeah.
right? You can have a rainy day maybe, or how do you deal with things like that? Because I feel that, you know, even if it's raining or the light is gone or something like that happens, how do you handle it?
Yeah, best thing is to plan for like contingencies and stuff, but not all, like everything doesn't go according to the plan all the time. Sometimes you need to improvise.
Thinking on your feet matters, I guess.
Yeah, a lot. So if it's raining, you make use of the rain actually, because a rainy picture sometimes gives like a really good look. Because say you put, for instance, you put the bride and groom under an umbrella, uh-huh. and you light the say the bride and groom from like under them, and you get some really nice effects.
You're able to work with any weather conditions then.
Yeah. We have no excuse. Yeah. We have been given a job. Mm-hmm. We are getting it done somehow. So, yeah.
All right then. So, we're going for a very short break once again. But we'll be back. We'll look at some more of your work, Dylan. And I think there are some photographs of Colombo that we have to look at. But right now, this is a song by Mark Anthony. Welcome back to the show, all about photography this morning, and I've had Dylan Sweden with me. We've been having a very lovely conversation about all the work you've done and also about how each of you at home can look better in pictures. And who doesn't want to look better in pictures, right? But now, speaking about some of the other work that you do, we've spoken about the weddings as well as the portraits that you do, but you do some landscape shots as well, and we have some beautiful shots that you've taken, Dylan. Yeah. I think we should have a look at those.
Yeah.
Especially since a very important festival is coming up. But before that, this is?
This shot was at in Singapore, mm-hmm. Which I went on a holiday, but
I see the famous merlion there. Yes.
Me being a photographer, we never go anywhere without my camera. So,
I'm sure.
So I took it there, and I actually took this picture mm-hmm. on the second day I was there. And actually, I put it on the market. I mean, I put it on Facebook. And then actually some companies who were in Singapore, mm-hmm. based in Singapore, contacted me wanting this picture.
Really?
Yeah. But they wanted exclusive rights to the picture, which I can't, that means I can't sell mm-hmm. again.
Yeah.
Exclusivity. Mm-hmm. which I thought, no, well, I can't, like, I really like this picture. This was...
And is that the sort of, did you have to look around a lot to find that angle and to get all of these buildings into the picture and, you know, get that sort of look to it?
Not exactly. I took a few pictures around that, mm-hmm. but in that angle pretty much covered like everything I wanted to show in the picture, mm-hmm. like the industrial zones and the composition. Again, about the composition.
Composition is
the
there.
Frame, because the frame is full in the two sides, mm-hmm. so that's something.
Things people can observe when they look at your photographs.
Yes.
But then there are some other pictures now. The Vesak season is coming up, and you've captured some images from last Vesak.
Yes.
So let's go see those as well.
Yeah.
Wow, so this is Colombo.
Yeah.
During the festival.
Have you ever seen Colombo this way?
No, I haven't actually. Wow, it looks so bright and how, I mean, you're very high up here, Dylan.
Yes.
What kind of lens do you have to go to get your pictures?
Oh, well, this was using a 16-35mm lens, mm-hmm. At around the 32nd floor.
So you went up there just to get these pictures, didn't
yeah.
you?
I told myself, like, I want a nice nightscape shot, mm-hmm. of Colombo, and even though all the Vesak traffic was going on, I thought, okay, we'll go somehow.
But again, I mean, there are challenges, a lot of challenges when it comes to photography as
yeah.
well. Let's speak about a bit of that. I mean, what are the real problems that you face when it comes to what you do?
Okay. Well, first of all, it's cost. Photography equipment is not cheap.
It's
pretty expensive.
Mm-hmm.
But there are people, like, you don't need the best equipment to create amazing pictures. You can work, but there are perks of having good equipment also. Basically, like, if you want to be a professional, mm-hmm. you got to use the best gear, as in to take the picture quickly. I mean, there are cameras that it's good enough for a wedding, but if you can't miss a moment. Especially modern wedding photographers,
mm-hmm.
you can't recreate the moment. Mm-hmm. You have to capture it while it happens.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So I'm sure you have a team that's with you as well, that support
yeah.
you when you do this. So have you like trained them up yourself, and now they know exactly, they think on the same frequency as you do?
Yep. At the start, they were learning a bit, but mm-hmm. now they know, okay, this shot I need to take at this wedding. This is a shot that he needs me to take. So now they are, like, it's streamlined. So they know what to do. That's how I get good wedding photographs.
Yes, well, and this is another shot. This is also during the Vesak season, isn't it?
Yes. But this is actually other side. The building on one side was the Vesak area, and this is the other side, towards the fort.
Side again, but the beautiful lights, and I'm sure that you'll be capturing more pictures during the coming Vesak season as well,
yep.
just next week. But so obviously photography has taken you to a lot of places, and you've seen a lot of things with a lot of people. I mean, again, that's another perk,
yeah.
I'm sure, of photography. But what's in store for you that's coming up next? Maybe something about, you know, being an international artist?
I wanted to take it with international.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, when like brides, like for now, I got some wedding inquiries that come from Hong Kong, and then I keep getting stuff from India, mm-hmm. and all. But yeah, it's a bit difficult due to like when you had to travel, you had to have at least a week.
Mm-hmm.
So I get booked like within the week, then you can't take an international wedding. So that happened to me about thrice now, where they wanted me to come for a week,
mm-hmm.
Before their wedding, but I have booking, so I don't.
But again, I'm sure that there are people who are watching at home as well, and some of them may be interested in photography, just amateur photographers, just starting out.
Yeah.
But what are the tools that you should set as your basics to build up on a good foundation? What are the things you really need to have?
The
sort of talents.